gosh, I almost just gave up on this whole thing. This has been a technical challenge this morning. Everything that could go wrong has gone wrong. Gail, there she is, number one, the winner. There's Leanne. Hi, Leanne. How you doing today, babe? Doug, hi. Hi, guys. All right, I was just saying, I swear, if Mercury's in retrograde or there's a full moon or some crap like that, because I could not get my technology to jive today. Anyway, morning. How are you? Happy Friday. What's going on? Hope you had a good week. What is planned this weekend? Got some good stuff. This weekend is my second wedding anniversary. Sharon and I, after, I don't know, it was, I guess, 15 years, got married 2 years ago. So we're still celebrating here in the Weekly McCormick household. Hey, Michael, what's up? Gail, is it a full moon? Okay, totally get it. Yeah, that's what's going on. All right, let's get to the question here. Let's get on with it. All right, here's my question for you. Are you playing an emotional game of chess with somebody? Are you playing an emotional game of chess? Are you in an emotional stalemate, very likely? Because when we play emotional games of chess, we usually end up in some sort of stalemate. So in chess, not that I play it, I just know enough to just know this, that a stalemate is basically where there are no more moves. Each player has made all the moves they can. There's not a winner. There's not a clear winner. Remember that. And the game's kind of over, which is fine if you're playing chess. But does that make any sense at all in a relationship? And I'm not just talking about a spouse or a boyfriend or a girlfriend. I'm talking about a sister, a mom, a friend, a coworker, any relationship. Can you think of one you have right now that you're playing a little emotional game of chess? And, you know, what that usually sounds like in a relationship is, well, if he would do this, then I would do this. Or if he would do more of this, then I would do that. Or if she only would say this, then I would say this. If they would show up this way, then I'd be more than happy to blah, blah, blah. It's this for that little game, right? And it usually ends up in some sort of stalemate where you're both just sticking your heels in the ground and saying, no, I'm not going to do that until you do that. And in business, you know, we learn, there's a great Zig Ziglar quote, and I'm probably botching it a little bit, but help people get what they want and you'll have everything that you want. It's one of my favorite quotes, and it works in business like a charm. I mean, it's kind of the magic sauce to sales, right? Figure out what your client needs, help them get it, and you'll have everything you want. And we all get that from a business standpoint really clearly, really easily. But if you lay that on top of personal relationships, it's exactly the same. Yet we don't look at our friend, partner, whatever, and say, how can I help them get what they want or get what they need? Because chances are that's what's happening, is neither party is actually getting what they need out of the relationship. So a lot of people say, you know, relationship is a 50-50. But I just read an article, I can't remember, I wish I could give credit to the author, but a relationship is really 200 and 200. It's everybody going kind of all in. So think about this as well, and we'll lay this all kind of all together here in the end. You know, people go where they're getting their significance. So let's go with the very stereotypical, I'm going to totally stereotype here. We'll just go with the classic one. The wife says, yeah, I would give more of what my husband wants. Mm-hmm, you know what I mean? If he would show up more, or help more around the house, or help with the kids. He could have everything he wants if he would just help me. And so that's the very stereotypical. I know it works the other way, and I know there are lots of other versions of that. But think about it. You're just in this giant stalemate. So what happens is the person who's not getting what they want from the relationship goes to find significance somewhere else. That's what we're all looking for, is significance. So if your husband is finding significance with his buddies on the golf course, that's where he'll be a lot. If she is finding significance with another man or another woman or whatever, that's where they'll go. Emotionally and or physically, it can go either way. People will go where they find significance. A lot of people find significance at work, so they work a lot, and it's like, God, that's all they do is work. Well, guys, that's where they're getting what they need. So if we, as their partners, their in life, their loves, if we could help them get what they need inside the house, inside the relationship, could that change? I guarantee it will change. It's just hard because we have to show up all in for them without any expectations for ourselves. That's a little challenging, isn't it? Hi, Cassie. What's up? How you doing, babe? Good to see you. So just a little something to think about. Instead of waiting for them to make the next move, why don't you go all in, help them get what they want in their life, and believe me, that will come back to you tenfold. Tressa, hi, babe. How was vacation? Hope it was good. All right, you'll be married 25 years next month. Ah, that is awesome. That is impressive. Way to go. What a partnership. Love that. You know, we got to dance. I think it's really time. So this is, for some of you, maybe a song you haven't heard. My sister, Erin, introduced me to this song. I can't get enough of it. Janelle Monae, you know Janelle. I'm actually going to go see her here in Cincinnati. She plays this song, Make Me Feel. And I thought this was perfect for what we were talking about. Hey, Becky, what's up? It's time for you to dance with me. Let's do this. Here we go. Such a good song. Erin said this is if Prince and Janet Jackson had a baby.
All of the feelings that I got for you can be explained, but I can try for you. You're baby to make me spell it out for you. You keep on asking me the same questions and second guessing all my intentions. She know by the way I use my compression.
Come on, Pamela.
But you got the answers to my confessions. It's like I'm powerful with a little bit of tender and emotional sexual bender. Mess me up, yeah, but no one does it better. There's nothing better. That's just the way you make me feel.
That's just the way you make me feel.
That's just the way you make me feel.
Janelle Monae, and it's called Make Me Feel, if you guys want to look that up, because I think you're probably going to want to. So Prince and Janet Jackson, right? All right, guys, I hope that helps. I hope that, I don't know, creates some thought in your brain. If you want to talk about it, if you have anything to share, I always would love to hear from you, okay? So I hope you guys have an awesome, awesome weekend. It's going to be hot here in the Natty, really hot. All right, guys, take care. Have a good week. See ya.